I haven't seen one of Clint Eastwood's films. And this is just to knock down my list of what videos to do, and plus I edited a couple. But anywho, this is my 10 recommendable Wii games. Now, my last video was my 15, you know, because it's a big library and all. But, you know, and I had a request from NickDud92, or aka, you know, the username up there, but I just call it NickDud92 anyways. But this is my 10 recommendable Wii titles. Now, it's a bit different to the Wii to the Xbox 360, because, you know, some titles, you know, come again and again and again and again and again and again, because you know, because I just like having them both, because, you know, it's completely different. But you know, because I got loads of money, I thought, why not? But, you know, it's just that it's just Xbox 360 is a bit different. But yeah, still, this is a 10 recommenders, no top 10s. I don't want any, you know, gay ass, you know, fanboy comments again. But the last video, which is the Xbox 360 one, turned out alright. Let's start off with number 10. Now, I know that I got all three Sonics on Nintendo Wii. Now, you got, like, the good daytime stuff then, comparing to all the other PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. You got the two story ones, which is the Arabian Nights and the Nights. You know, Arabian Nights and the medieval thing, but I prefer, you know, the good old, because it's the most recommendable, because the other one was alright, the you know, Arabian Nights one, but this is kind of alright, so that's that, you know, because there was this one certain someone, because they probably don't ask, but anywho, right. The next one is Mad's World. Now, Mad's World is really good, because you got a point counting system. I know it's not like your average beat 'em up level by level, but it's all to do with the points. Now, killing certain people in a certain sort of way, you know, hack and slash and all that, but, you know, it delivers really good points system game, so you can continue onwards. But it's a really good recommender, really bloody for a Wii title, because it is cult, because Wii is sometimes a culture game. Wii is sort of a console culture thing. Next one is Resident Evil 4 Wii Edition. Now, the Wii Edition is the best Resident Evil of them all. Now people are going to say, why are you not playing Resident Evil 5? It's because I'm used to the really good controlling system on this, because it's my first Resident Evil game out of 1, 2 and 3 and onwards. But, you know, it's just that this is a really good title, and plus the controls, and it's just brilliant, this is. Next one is a Wii exclusive, and that is Boom Blocks. Now, this has a really good level editing system comparing to stuff like Little Big Planet and other types of leveling editing systems. But this has a really good level editing system, and you can make, like, sprites or 18-bit sprites, 18? 8-bit sprites and other types of variations. But it's a really good recommender, and plus good for parties and all of that, just really good. Highly recommendable for the Nintendo Wii. Most highly recommendable, and the last one I'll say that's in this pile that I'll say in the end, but this is mostly the recommendable, you know, the good old Super Smash Bros. Brawl. Yeah, come on! Level editing system, again, still, you know, has a good level editing system. Battles, lagging connection is alright, but you got battles, story modes, it's just endless possibilities that can go on, but highly recommendable. Super Mario Galaxy! Now this is, it goes back to the old Nintendo 64 days when you have to collect stars and all that, and it's originated its patterns back into the Nintendo 64 days, but it's alright as a recommendable, but in case you people are like, oh, I need more Nintendo games, but this is a really good recommendable. Really good story, and plus sometimes for hacks, the Twilight hack, if you know what I mean, but Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess, really good story, just hours and hours of storyline and gameplay. You know, you just can't get enough with Zelda these days with Zelda on the Nintendo platform. But really recommendable. For you, I know there's loads of first-person shooters out there, but there's like Medal of Honor Heroes 2, that's really good as multiplayer and stuff like that. And plus like Quantum of Solace, which just doesn't count stuff. But, you know, Metroid Prime 3 Corruption. Even though it is a Wii exclusive, the control scheme is quite good with the pointer and stuff like that. And using the nunchuck as the grappler, and really good story, and continue onwards and finishes off, or nearly finish off, because I don't know if they'll make any more games, but, you know, it's just really and then plus it brings back some old stuff, like the good old Metroids that eats your blooming head off and all that kind of stuff, but, yeah, good first-person shooter game. And plus, as you may have known, speaking about first-person shooters, Red Steel 2 is going to be out. Hope it turns all right in the first one. I don't want to get any bad comments for that. But anyway, another Wii exclusive. WarioWare Smooth Moves. Epic craziness, because, you know, you got, like, hula hooping, jumping, and all that. Even though it's a one-player game, even though it's got the hot potato thing with the one remote, but still, it is really good, and, you know, you just get so much, you know, craziness out of it. You know, that's why, because this shows really good capabilities with the Wii remote, you know, turn it into a phone, and why am I always saying the discard phone? I don't know why, it's my favourite one. You know, you got hula hooping, you know, you got other types of stuff. Always say the discard phone. You know, you might know why. Even Lewis Pierce knows what I mean. Alright, even though that Super Smash Bros. Brawl was the highly recommendable, but this is kind of like second. Oh, by the way, I know there's loads of Wii ones, like Wii Sports, Wii Fit, Wii This, Wii That, Wii Chess, Wii Music, Wii That, Wii Shit. You know, why am I saying Wii Shit? But anyway, but you know, there's like other types of Wii ones. Wii Sports isn't included because in this recommendable, because it comes with the Wii. Because Wii Sports is really good because it shows off really good capabilities with the Wii remote and stuff like that. And you got like Wii Play that shows the capabilities with the Wii remote. And plus you got like Legend of Zelda, I forgot the Zelda Zappo game now. But you know, that shows the capabilities with the Zappo. But you know, this show's really good recommendable for those that need to get fit, even though I do. But this is a really, really fitness game, even though that it has some culture stuff, so you can do like skiing and stuff like that. It's most recommendable, even though it's cost about 70 quid these days here in the UK, but it is the top rated sort of thing. You know, even though that Super Smash Bros. Brawl is meant to be for hardcorers, but still, you know, this is mostly good, because if you think about it, you can't go wrong with a Wii Fit balance board, because, you know, it's the most fitness regime thing ever since the Nintendo DS came out with the whole brain training thing. But, you know, well, you know, that's just my 10 recommendables. You know, this is why, you know, Xbox 360 has a big library and I already got them like twice. You know, twice, but as you may have saw at the beginning of the video, but you know, it's just that you know, it's just that Wii Sports isn't included because, you know, it comes with the Wii, and there's alright Wii titles, you know, there's just not much hardcore. I just hope that Nintendo E3 this year, 2009, comes out quite well, because last year was shit, if you know what I mean, you know, drum beat and all that. Well, I hope they do quite well. But anywho, that's my 10 recommendable Wii titles. And now I'm going to get some fanboyish comments, but I have all three consoles now. Don't ditch me. Sorry, I'm just a bit moody today because of one person. But anywho, I just thought I'd get this video over and done with and it's marked off on my list. So anyways, I better go now. That's that story. In case any of you like to request like a DS1 and sooner or later, a PlayStation 3 one, but we'll have to see. See you from CG Films.